In this video, we are going to discuss firewall penetration testing steps, methods, and tools. So let's start with the firewall. We have created separate firewall training course. So you can check out my YouTube playlist. So firewall is the first line lines of defense in preventing cyber attacks in every organization. So this is the an opportunity for penetration tester that threat actors like to attempt the exploit that would be a compromise in network security. So let's start with the firewall penetration process. So firewall penetration testing is the process of locating, investigate, and penetrating a certain firewall in order to reach the internal trusted network of certain system. So most considered to the key part of in external network penetration testing, firewall penetration testing is the one of the most important type of network penetration test that can be conducted at firewall represent the first line of defense against the outside step to perform a firewall penetration test. So there are 8 steps to perform firewall penetration testing, which include the locating the firewall, conducting the trace route, scanning ports, banner grabbing, firewall enumeration, testing the firewall policy, firewalking its Kali Linux tool, and the last one is the identify the firewall vulnerability. Firewall penetration testing tools. So most important tools need for firewall penetration testing are scanner, including Nmap. We can use a telnet, traceset, traceroute, hping3, and firewall network auditing tool. Step one, locating the firewall. So every firewall penetration test will be beginning with the locating the firewall. So using any packet craft software like hping3 and Nmap, the tester craft specific IP packets containing UDP, TCP or ICMP payloads. So depending on the level of aggression of the scan one wish to perform, hp3 is better choice to avoid abnormal activity from being detected. Let's start with the locating the firewall. So we have to identify the our firewall IP address and where it is located. So let's start with the hping3. So this is the tool we can find in Kali Linux, and we can do using the command also sudo for the admin rights. Hping3 tool -t for traceroute, -1 for the against the target, and here we target one website like firewalldemo.com. okay, and just enter. So after that you will identify the all the routes for the to reach the website. So so we can identify the our firewall. So this is the my VMware IP address, and this is the my gateway IP address. So this is the my firewall IP address, and after that it's redirect to my ISP, and after that it's able to reach the website IP address. So this is the our practical lab for locating the firewall, how we can identify the firewall IP address, and you can check it out. Step 2, conducting the traceroute. Network range can be identified by running a traceroute commands against the firewall located in previous step. This step will also provide the information regarding the route routing routing path of the packet. So it whenever you use the traceroute command, so it's identify the routes of route the packet between system or and determine the all the routers or any all the network device that are involved in the connection of establishing the process. So additionally, certain information we can penetrate to the device to filter the traffic and protocol used can be also obtained using a trace route. So in Linux system, we are using a trace route. For example, google.com. In Windows system, it's use a traceat command with, for example, traceat google.com. Here is the, we can identify the our firewall IP or gateway IP using a trace route command. Let's do the practical for the same. Now conducting the trace route. So network runs can be identified by running the traceat commands against the particular website and any particular IP address or any network device. So this step will provide the information regarding the route packets take between the system to determine all the router or net or network device are involved in the connection to establishing the process. So for example, for Windows, we are using a traceat command, and in Linux, trace route command. Right now we are checking with the traceat command. Windows system, this is the one website. demo.com. So let's just a minute. Firewall demo.com. So it's the tracing route to a particular hosted platform and IP address. And this is the our network gateway IP address of our firewall. This is the my WAN IP IP address. This is the native IP address, and it's all it's involved all the network device or all the routers which are involved in the establishing the connection. So now traceat is complete. To reach the particular our website, we have 10 hops between the our system IP address system to destination. So this is all the device are involved in to establish a connection for the process. This is the third step in firewall penetration testing methodology. Is a port scan. Port scanning, the most commonly used tool is NMAP for the penetration testing. So in this step, not only we identify the open ports on the firewall, but also identify the corresponding service that are running on the open ports using NMAP. So for example, NMAP hyphen SS hyphen P, we have mentioned the well-known port range from 0 to 1025 and firewall IP and hyphen T4. So here is the, we can use a SYN flag and hyphen P for port range and hyphen T for speed of scanning. After mapping all necessary ports and determining the that ones that port are in open state, the penetration tester can run another NMAP scan on the ports to determine which service are running and running the following NMAP scan will be provide the information. You can use the NMAP hyphen SV firewall IP and hyphen T1. So after crafting and running the different NMAP scan, the penetration tester will have a basic overview of firewall and open ports and service running on those ports using a second command. So let's do the practical for the same. Now SHAP 3 port scanning. So for the port scanning, we can do it from the LAN zone and also WAN zone. But right now we are doing from the LAN zone. So sudo admin rights nmap hyphen as sync flag hyphen p for port numbers 0 to 1024. We are right now scanning only well known ports and firewall IP address 0.1 and hyphen t for scanning speed. Password of admin. So it's starting the nmap process. Just wait for the few minutes. Now process is finished. So we can identify the nmap scan report for a particular IP. So it's our firewall IP host is up. This is our latency and 1021 port filter ports means it's blocked by the firewall. So whenever we are accessing from LAN to WAN or any other zone, these ports, it's by default blocked. Open ports is 22, open state is open, SSH, 80, TCP, open, HTTP, 443, open, and it's a HTTPS protocol service. So here we are doing scanning from the LAN zone. You can do it from the WAN also to identify. Step 4, banner grabbing. Performing the banner grabbing on firewall will provide the information on the version of firewall. This information can be later used to find the vulnerability of particular version, so we can exploit that. So we can find most in Google hacking database. This is the method for the banner grabbing process. We can use nmap tool curl command and telnet and netcat and dimritter. It's a Kali Linux tool. So we can easily do the process for a banner grabbing firewall. So let's do the practical with the telnet and nmap. Now we can do the banner grabbing process for the firewall. So sudo for the admin rights nmap hyphen as we are using a nmap script here for banner grabbing. You can use your telnet as well, as so you need to telnet particular that IP and port number, so you can grab the banner of firewall. Right now we are using nmap, so you can do it from the telnet also 0.1. So here is we are using our firewall IP address, so let's enter root password. Now it's starting the nmap process. Just wait for the some time. Now process is finished. So we can identify the 997 ports are filters. Port 22 TCP, it's open, and service SSH version is open, SSH 7.4. So we can identify, and protocol 2.0. So we can identify that version in Google hacking database if is there any vulnerability related to the open SSH 7.4, and so we can identify is there any vulnerability regarding that particular version. So this is the SSH 2.0 open SSH 7.4. port 80 is working HTTP Apache, so HTTP server header is Apache, and port is 443 TCP open SSL HTTP means HTTPS, it's also Apache. So this is the service detection performed by nmap against the firewall for banner grabbing process. Step 5, firewall enumeration. So every firewall have configured some policy rule set. So in order to determine the which traffic to allow or deny from the internal network, the only indicator of penetration tester can observe while enumerating to access the control list or firewall rule set of the ports on the firewall. So NMAP can be used for the firewall enumeration technique. So let's start with the command NMAP hyphen SA firewall IP and hyphen T3 192.168.0.1 is my firewall IP. So hyphen SA means send the acknowledgement flag, and hyphen T3 is the speed of the type scanning. So here is the NMAP will send the packet to the first well-known port 1025 ports with the acknowledgement flag raised. The return traffic results that indicate that is firewall is open, filter or unfiltered. So if the if the port is open state, so it indicates the listening mode. If the state of port is filtered, then it's blocked by the firewall. Finally, if the port is unfiltered state, so we can say that the traffic is passing through the firewall. Means firewall is the passing the traffic through the port, but the port is not open. So let's do with the practical. Now let's we can do the banner grabbing process for the firewall. So sudo for the admin rights and hyphen as the script. We are using a nmap script here for banner grabbing. You can use your telnet as well as, so you need to telnet particular that IP and port number, so you can grab the banner of firewall. Right now we are using nmap, so you can do it from the telnet also 0.1. so here is we are using our firewall IP address, so let's enter root password. Now it's starting the nmap process. Just wait for the some time. Now process is finished. So we can identify the 997 ports are filters. Port 22 TCP, it's open, and service SSH version is open SSH 7.4. So we can identify, and protocol 2.0. So we can identify that version in Google hacking database if is there any vulnerability related to the open SSH 7.4, and so we can identify is there any vulnerability regarding that particular version. So this is the SSH 2.0 open SSH 7.4. port 80 is working HTTP Apache, so HTTP server header is Apache, and port is 443 TCP open SSL HTTP means HTTPS, it's also Apache. So this is the service detection performed by NMAP against the firewall for banner grabbing process. Step 6, testing the firewall policy. So in step 6, we are test the firewall rule set, test the web filter policy. So there are two methods to test the firewall policy. You can test with the firewall policy like source IP, source port, destination IP, destination port. And you can test via also zone based that you wish to test that. And using the test a web filter policy. So web policy that you wish to test, you can include other parameter like particular URL and particular authenticated user, or on particular time or on particular day. So we can test the firewall policy in step 6. Step 7, firewalking. So firewalking is the tool and method of mapping the network device that sit behind the firewall. The firewall network auditing tool analyze the packet written by the firewall with the use of threshold techniques. So it will determine the open ports on firewall by checking the device behind the firewall and identify which traffic is able to pass the firewall. So the firewall tool is considering to perform advanced network mapping. So it's able to paint a picture of network topology. Here is the, we can see the one graphical so for the firewalking. So more specially, by crafting the packets with certain TTL value, the penetration test can be identified the open ports if the return message is received with the exit TLL. If no response is received, it can be concluded that the firewall filter the packet and block the connection. We are using a firewall Kali Linux tool. So let's do the practical. Now let's discuss the firewall tool in Kali Linux. We have already discussed regarding the firewall tool. It's active recon network security tool. For you need to first download from the GitLab, and you can clone that particular GitHub directory, or you can install using as one simple command apt install firewall. Sudo is for the root access. So after that, I have installed using a command. Then I am able to find the firewall keys here, password, and in firewall option target gateway metric and hyphen D for a destination port, hyphen H for help, hyphen I for interface, hyphen N for do not resolve IP address into host name, hyphen P for particular protocol TCP or UDP, hyphen R for restrict the RFC, and you can scan the particular port range, and you can also mention the particular source port and T1 for the packet read out time, small t1 for the IP time to leave, V for program version, and hyphen X for the expire vector. So I have proceed the particular command. So here is the command sudo firewall hyphen D is for destination port 543, and you can mention 80443 which port you want to scans again the firewall tool. Hyphen I for your interface. So this is the VM lab interface. So I have mentioned that it is 0. Hyphen N for do not resolve the IP to hostname, hyphen P TCP protocol. This is the my system IP address, VM system IP address, and this is the target of particular global DNS IP. So I have it's proceed for the TTL 1 to TTL 25, and you can able to see the response. If is any, we will get the response. Right now it's no response because I have mentioned the port 543. So you can identify the total packet sent, total packet error, total packet caught, and total port scan and open and unknown. So if you have mentioned any port range, send, then you are able to particular find the particular port range. So for example, we are doing for the port against the IP address my firewall. Let's see what happened. 0.1. Capital S for the port range. Here is the port range is particular, we are find the particular regarding the 543 port. Let's scan. So it's a TCP based scan because we have used the protocol TCP. Wrapping the first source port 543 and destination port 3343 because we have used the source ports. Just check with the destination port and D. because 543 port is open at our firewall end. So just wait for the some time. So it will check by the particular T1 by checking the TTL value. Here we can set the scan abroad hop count exceed. So total packet sign, total packet error codes. For example, here is a firewall. This is the source port range. Hyphen is Ethernet 0. Hyphen N is do not resolve the IP address. Hyphen P protocol. This is the IP address of system, and this is the target IP address. So firewall gateway ACL scanner. So it TCP based scan and TTL1 expired in 192.168.1.1 binding host scan bound to hops. So port it's no response, 80 is open, 8081 is no response. So total packet sent 4. Total packet code 2. Code of interest and scan and open port. It's all about the firewall port. Step 8, identify the firewall vulnerability. So first off, we have to disabling the service that we are not needed, and checking the firewall configuration is the only way to ensure the safety. If we are not using any service, so make sure it's disabled at firewall end, so we can secure the networks. And for finding the firewall vulnerability, we can visit the website cvedetails.com. So in that website we can find the particular vendor based firewall vulnerability and particular the version based the vulnerability. So that's in this website we can able to find the if any present vulnerability is available for particular version, so we can patch that particular vulnerability. So you can identify the firewall vulnerability by vendor or by product. So let's visit for the website cvedetails.com. Step 8, identify the firewall vulnerability. So first off, we have to disabling the service that we are not needed, and checking the firewall configuration is the only way to ensure the safety. If we are not using any service, so make sure it's disabled at firewall end, so we can secure the networks. And for finding the firewall vulnerability, we can visit the website cvedetails.com. So in that website we can find the particular vendor based firewall vulnerability and particular the version based the vulnerability. So that's in this website we can able to find the if any present vulnerability is available for particular version, so we can patch that particular vulnerability. So you can identify the firewall vulnerability by vendor or by product. So let's visit for the website cvedetails.com. Let's visit for the cvedetails website. You can identify the particular products base and vulnerability base and vulnerability by date, search vulnerability, and you can identify the particular CVVS code distribution. So just checking with the CVV details. For example, you can search here particular firewall. So you can get the many vulnerabilities regarding the any product related to firewall. So in Indian firewall checkpoint, this is the also for the FileScape personal firewall, Barracuda. So you can identify any product related, any firewall product related the vulnerability if you search the particular in firewall. So you can also search by vendor, for example. Here vendor search, we can search CyberRoom. So we can get the CyberRoom related particular vulnerabilities. Year wise number of vulnerabilities and code execution, and you can check it out for the any product, for example. Now let's check with the Sophos. So you can identify the Sophos related all the vulnerabilities. Palo Alto. So you can identify the vulnerabilities regarding the Palo Alto. Just check it out with your vendor, which is you are using a firewall checkpoint. Sorry, spelling mistake. So it's all about the vulnerabilities regarding the checkpoint. So you need to check the vulnerabilities and on which version is available. So if is there any patches available to overcome this vulnerability. So you can patch the particular vulnerability, or you can upgrade your firewall with the minimum vulnerabilities is available in that particular firmware. So it's all about the how to we can identify the vulnerabilities of any firewall.